Welcome students to Learn It. In this topic, we'll be taking Unit 1, Planning in Sports, Topic 1 of Physical Education. So let's begin with the content. The first content which we'll be talking about is the starting 3 points, and the last 3 points we'll be taking in our next video. In the first content, first point says meaning and objectives of planning. Now, in this topic, we'll be talking about what is the importance, what is the basic meaning, and what is the basic objective of planning any of the programs, any of the games. Now, the second point we'll be describing is various committees and their responsibilities. So, after planning, or before planning, or during planning, we have to take some responsibilities or give responsibilities to some of the various committees so that we can work in a planning manner. We will be describing here 3 topics, which is pre-planning, during, and post. Last topic for this video content will be tournament. Tournament has been divided into many parts, but mainly some important topics are knockout tournament, league tournament, league is also called round robin tournament, and combination tournament. In this topic, we'll be talking about meaning of planning. Here is the basic definition of planning: a basic management functions involving the making of one or more plans to achieve needs or demand with the available resource. In simple terms, we can say that it means deciding in advance what is to be done, when it is to be done, how it is to be done, and by whom it is to be done. It refers to the task or goal or target or demand or need. Planning depends on many functions which has to be in a coordinated manner. For example, if we take a marriage function, everything has to be perfect, from cooking the food, from decorating the stages, from arranging the chairs, from getting all the necessary requirements to make a marriage successful. In this topic, we will be discussing about objectives of planning. Now, there are some of the objectives by which our planning can be in effective, creative, and in a good manner. The first point described is to keep good control over all the activities we have been planning. Second is to facilitate proper coordination between the players, between the teams, between the coordinators, etc. To reduce any chances of mistake happening in the program, happening in the sports, happening in a team. To increase the efficiency of the team, of the program, to increase creativity in different kinds of manner, to enhance the performance of the team and as an individual also, to reduce the unnecessary pressure of immediacy, which means at the last spot we don't want to get many things which we don't have. In various committees and their responsibilities, to get a work done, or in other words we can say that to coordinate in a good manner for an event, we have to create some sort of committees which will take the responsibilities of that individual task. So here are some of the committees which will help us in a better planning. The first is the committee for publicity. Now, what is the committee for publicity is, they will publicize like in social medias, like in televisions, like in pamphlets, like in newspapers. All the things will be publicized by this committee for publicity. Second is the transport committee. Transport committee will help to transport different kinds of material from one place to another. The third is boarding and lodging committee. It mainly contains of taking one team's material and all the team members from one place to another, from one hotel to another, and help them to be in a hotel or at a place where they will stay for the time duration. The fourth is decoration and ceremony committee. This is all around the grounds where you can see many of the hoardings, many companies advertisements, etc. Fifth is ground and equipment committee. They will take all the necessary material required for that team, required for that sports, etc. Sixth point is refreshment and entertainment committee. Seventh is reception committee. Reception committee means whenever, whatever they will be doing, if they have any of the task which has to be performed in a single day, any of the sports which has a limited timing, any event has to come under reception committee. Eighth point is committees on entries and programs. They will have the list of the different kinds of programs happening at different places. Next is committee for officials. Committee for officials means in this we can describe many like referees, umpires, etc., which are important for that game. 10 in announcements committee. Announcement committee announces all the things to the news channel also, to the live televisions also. These are the announcement committee. And 11th is the first aid committee. If any of the incident happen on field or off field, this first aid committee will come into play. Move on from our planning session, we will be moving on to tournaments. Now, if we can describe what is tournament is, it is that series of sports in which a team finally wins and rest of the team loses the match. Tournament is a place where two teams play and any one team wins so that one team can lose. Now, there is some of the importance for the tournament also. Why tournament has been happening and why it is so popular. First is, it develops sports skill individually also and as in team effort also. Second is propaganda of the sports. Sometimes sports can be for different purposes. Like sometimes it can be for careness, sometimes it can be for a social cause, etc. Helpful. Third point is helpful in selection of players. When we have this kind of tournament, we can decide which player is good, which team is good, and which can be selected into the next level or to represent a nation. Fourth point is development of national and international integration. Fifth is development of social qualities like sportsmanship, leadership skills, social skills, etc. Sixth point is sources of recreation. Now, what do you mean by sources of recreation is, you can recreate different kinds of things. You can't just kick a ball with a single technique. You can use different methods to kick a ball so that you can recreate a different era or a different method. Basically, there are four types of tournament. The first is the knockout tournament. Second one is league or round robin tournament. Third is combination tournament. And the fourth one is the seeding tournament. Now we will be moving on to the types of tournaments. First topic, which is the knockout tournament. In simple terms, we can say that this is the most common type of tournament in which teams play against each other. Winner moves to the next round, whereas loser is eliminated from the tournament. Which you can say that if two teams are playing, one team will win and second will lose. If a team is winning continuously, it will be kept in the tournament. If a team loses at any moment, they will be out of the tournament. That is the basic meaning of knockout tournament, which means if you lose, you will be knocked out from the tournament. It has some advantages and disadvantages. When we are moving on to the advantages, it takes less time for a knockout tournament. It takes less money. Less officials are needed for this kind of tournaments. And it also enhances standards of sports. And when we are moving to the disadvantages, the chances of elimination of a very good team in the first round itself or in the second round itself of the tournament is much possible. Second is maximum chance of weak team to enter into the finals, because by chance if a weak team plays good and a
good team plays as a weak contender, they will be kicked out of the tournament. Last is, spectator may not have enough interest in the final match. If a weak team goes into the tournament, for example, in a cricket match, if we take any of the weakest team which will be going into the finals, nobody will be watching their game. So basic meaning is, spectators may not have enough interest in the final match. The second point in this tournament is league, which is also called as round robin tournament. In this type of tournament, all teams are made to compete with each other for once. So let me distinguish between knockout tournament and a league round tournament or a league round robin tournament. It is basically, in the knockout tournament, if you win, you go into the next round, and if you lose, you will be knocked out. But in case of league, each team has to play with each different team of that league, and on that basis the winner is decided. As in case of ICC World Cup of Cricket, this league or round robin tournament has been happening. Now, it has also been divided into two types, or the types of league tournament are: first is single league tournament, and second is double league tournament. In single league tournament, every team plays with each other team only once. And in double league tournament, every team plays with every other team twice. So I hope you have understood what is knockout tournament and what is league or round robin tournament. Now we'll be moving on to the method of preparing fixtures. Now, what do you mean by fixtures? Fixture is basically a technique by which a team, it is decided which team will be playing with which team and how many times they will be playing, so that we can decide a winner. Now, it has three methods, which is cyclic method, staircase method and tabular method. Now, for this year, tabular method has not been included in the syllabus, so we'll be talking about two things only. One is cyclic method and second is staircase method.
Now we'll be moving on to the combination tournament. Now, what does the combination means is, we have already discussed what is knockout tournament and what is league or round robin tournament. When we combine these two in different manners, we can create four kinds of tournaments, which is also known as combination tournament. The names are given below. One is knockout cum knockout tournament, league cum league tournament, knockout cum league tournament, and league cum knockout tournament. These are the four kinds of combination tournament which we'll be studying. Now we'll have moved on to the combination tournament. In combination tournament, the first point comes as knockout cum knockout. Now, what do you mean by knockout tournament? I'll just again describe it. Here's team plays against each other and winner moves to the next round, whereas loser is eliminated from the tournament. Now, what does it means? I'll just show with an example. This is a layout of zonal tournament on knockout basis. So there are four zones basically. One is zone A, zone B, zone C and zone D. And in each zone, there are four teams each, which means in zone A, there are four teams, which is team number one, team number two, team number three and team number four. Now, what happens in knockout basis is, in knockout, one teams play with other team and only one team wins and other team is directly eliminated. So, for example, in zone A, we take team number 1 and team number 2. They will be having a match, and for example, if team 1 wins, it will go into the next round. Same in zone A, if team number 3 and team number 4 have a match, and if a team number 3 wins, which means from 1 and 2, 1 wins, and from 3 and 4, 3 wins, which means in the next round, team 1 and team 3 win will have a match, and whoever wins, for example, if team number 3 wins, then the winner from zone A will be team number 3. Same will be going for zone B, same will be for zone C and for zone D. From each zone, we will be having four kinds of winners. From zone A, winner A. From zone B, it will be winner B. From zone C, it will be winner C. And from zone D, it will be winner D. These are the four kinds of zones. Now, first kind of knockout tournament has taken place and we got four winners. Now, as we have suggested the names, it is knockout come knockout, which means there will be two knockout matches. So in zone A, B, C, D, we got four winners. We'll be moving them into the next knockout basis, which is known as interzonal tournament on knockout basis, which is given below, in which we have teams of winner A, winner B, C and D. All the zone winners are there. We'll be having a match between winner A and B. Whoever wins goes to the next round, which is also known as finals. Winner C and winner D will have a match, and whichever wins the match will move into the final. And ultimately, whoever wins in the final will be assumed as a winner. So this is basically the knockout come knockout tournament. And in same scenario, we'll be discussing our next topic also. Let's move on to the combination tournament. In combination tournament, we have our second topic, which is league come league or league round robin come league round robin tournament. In this, all teams are made to compete with each other for once. For example, we have an example of group of zonal tournament on league basis. In this, we have zone A, zone B, zone C and zone D as we had in knockout tournament. The same zones are there. In zone A, we can see a bracket in which it is written 1-2, 1-3, 1-4 and so on. Now, why it has been written like this is one team, which is known as team A or team 1, can always have a match with only team 2, team 3 or team 4. It can't have a match with team 1 again. That's why it is written 1-2, 1-3 and 1-4. So all the probabilities for team 1 has been completed. Team 1 can play only 3 matches with the 3 teams only. If there are 4 teams in a zone, then. Now, as we can see, in the second line it has written 2-3, 2-4 and there is nothing written there 2-2, because 2 team cannot have a match with its own team. That's why. So it can only have 3 alternatives, that is 2 can have a match with team 1, team 2 can have a match with team 3 and 2 can have a match with team 4. So all the probabilities for them also completed. Now in the last it is written team 3 has a match with team 4 because all the probabilities has already been completed in the above section. That's why it is written team will have 3 probabilities. Team 3 can have a match with team 1, team 3 can have a match with team 2, team 3 can have a match with team 4. So all the probabilities has been completed in this zone. In this zone A and zone B, if you are looking, all the zones are same. Basically, this method in zone A has been used in different zones also. And after all the zones have had a match with each other, at least a single time, we can predict a winner who has the highest number of matches win. The winner from zone A, B, C and D will go into the next league tournament, which is intergroup or zonal tournament on league basis, where we will be taking team A will compete with team B once, team A will compete with team C and team A will compete with team D. Same as team B will compete with team C, team B will compete with team D and team B will compete with team A. And last, a team C will compete in team D. Whoever wins the highest number of matches will be assumed as a winner. Now we'll be moving on to the third topic of combination tournament. The topic is knockout come league tournament. For example, group or zonal tournament on knockout basis has been given down below, in which we have four teams, zone A, B, C, D, which are playing a knockout tournament. And when we are looking down below, there are four teams which has been arranged in a league tournament manner, which means we have combination of two things. Above it is knockout tournament and below it is league tournament. When we decide winners from knockout tournament, the winner will directly go into the next round and they will play the next match in league basis, so that we can have different kinds of winners. In the next kind of combination tournament, it is league cum knockout tournament. And what does in league cum knockout tournament happened is, it's just the opposite of knockout cum league tournament as we had just discussed previously. In this kind of tournament, the first zone A, B, C, D will have a match in a knockout, in a league cum knockout basis, in a league basis, and whenever the team wins as a winner, A, B, C, D will move on to the interzonal tournament, and there they will be playing on the basis of knockout tournament. This kind of combination tournament has been prevailing in cricket since a very long time, and Cricket World Cup has been happening in such a manner only. That's it for today's video. I hope you have understood what I have taught you. For better understanding, I urge all of you to again go through this slide so that you can understand it well, especially in fixtures area. For next thing, please stay tuned to the channel. If you have any kind of problem regarding any of the things, you can comment down below. Till next time, stay safe, stay healthy, and please do learn it. Thank you.